Hello students, how are you? So let's start with 5th standard environmental studies. So children, today we will see chapter number 15, blow hot, blow cold. So actually it is not a chapter, it is a story. And do you know students who has been written this story? So this story has been written by Dr. Zakir Hussain, former president of India. He has written many stories. This is one of the story written by him, Dr. Zakir Hussain. So let's see, this story is very interesting and related to your daily life also. So you will feel that this is not a different kind of story, it is related with you and your daily life. So there was a woodcutter, and every day in the morning he used to go to the forest to cut wood. In the evening he would sell the wood in the city, as woodcutter's work is that to cut the wood and to sell it in the city and to earn money. One day he went deep into the forest. It was a very cold winter. His fingers were becoming numb. What is the meaning of numb? Numb meaning not able to feel anything or not able to move. Means in the cold we are not able to feel anything on our fingers. So his fingers becoming numb. Every now and then the woodcutter would put down his axe and bring his hands close to his mouth, and then he would blow hard on them to warm them. He was bringing his hands together and towards the mouth, and he was blowing hard on the hands. So while he was cutting wood, Mian Baliste was watching him from a corner. Mian Baliste is very small character, you can see it in the picture. So Mian Baliste saw that the woodcutter kept blowing on his hands. He began to wonder what all that was about, but he could not understand it. He got up thinking that he would go and ask the woodcutter. Means he was thinking that he will go to woodcutter and he will ask what is going on. After walking a little, he came back thinking that the woodcutter may not like being asked. Means if the Mian Baliste was thinking, if he will ask to woodcutter, so woodcutter may not, sometimes he will not feel good, he will feel bad. So again he stopped. But finally Mian Baliste could not help himself. He went hopping to the woodcutter and said, "Hello brother, if you don't mind, can I ask you something?" And he asked. Seeing this tiny person, the woodcutter was amazed and amused also. But he hid his smile. Now here HID, that is the past tense of HIDE, hide. So means that woodcutter said, of course, ask what you want to. All I want to ask is, why do you blow from your mouth on your hands?" said Mian Baliste. Mian Baliste asked question to woodcutter, that why do you blow from your mouth on your hands? You can also do this activity and you can feel the breath on your hands. Then woodcutter replied, "It is too cold. My hands are frozen. So I blow on them to warm them up a little." Hands are cool and the mouth, he was blowing from his mouth, so that vapors are little bit warmer than the outermost cool atmosphere. Then why they get cold again, I warm them again by blowing. So Mian Baliste nodded. So that's it. And with that he moved off. Means he came to know that that Mian Baliste now got his answer, that why woodcutter was blowing on his hands. So what a woodcutter replied, that it is too cold and that hands are frozen, so he was blowing on his hand to warm them up a little. So Mian Baliste got his answer and he nodded his head. Now soon it was afternoon. Mian Baliste was over there only, means he was keeping watch on that woodcutter. Now in the afternoon, what has happened again? See children, the woodcutter began to think of lunch. Now woodcutter was hungry, so he began to think of lunch. He picked up two stones and made a chula. With the help of two stones, he made chula. And he lit a fire and put a small handi or pot filled with potatoes to boil. He kept a pot on the that two stones to boil potatoes. The wood was damp. So the woodcutter bent down and blew on the fire to help it to burn. Now, because that wood was not getting a fire because it was wet and damp, so woodcutter was means he bent down and blew on the fire to help it to burn. Baliste was watching him from the distance. "Arre," he said to himself, "there he goes again, blowing from his mouth. Does fire come out of his mouth?" Again, one question was there in the mind of Mian Baliste, that why that woodcutter is blowing now? Fire is coming out of from his mouth or what? Woodcutter was feeling very hungry. So he took out potato from the handi. He tried to eat it, but the potatoes was too hot. Now he took out the potatoes from the pot and he tried to eat, but the potatoes was potato was too hot. So he again began to blow on it. Just like you can when you're blowing, no, when the tea is hot, milk is hot, at that time you're blowing, just like you're doing on that. Okay, so he was also doing the same. So you have to note down the situation over here, children. In the first situation, Mian Baliste was blowing on his hands to keep them warm. Now here see the condition. When the wood was not blowing, again woodcutter was when that woodcutter kept the wood inside that chulha, so the wood was damp. So the woodcutter bent down and he blew on the fire to help it to burn. This is second situation. In the third situation, you have seen that the potatoes were very hot. Now the woodcutter was blowing on it to keep it cool, to make it cool. So "arre," he said to himself, "there he goes again, blowing from his mouth. Does fire come out from his mouth?" When he was blowing on the wood, then the woodcutter was when he took out the potatoes, at that time the potatoes were hot. So again he began to blow on the potatoes. So "arre," said Baliste to himself, "he is blowing again. Now what? Is he going to burn the potato?" Now in the first situation he saw that to burn that wood he was blowing. Now he was thinking, when he was blowing on the potato, is he going to burn that potato? So his thinking was like that. So after blowing a few more fufus on it, means fufus means what? He was blowing air from his mouth. The woodcutter put it in his mouth and began to eat it. Now the potato became cool, and then after that he was eating that potato. Now Mian was very surprised. He just could not stop himself, and off he went hopping to the woodcutter. "Hello, brother," he said. "If you don't mind, can I ask you a question again?" Mian Baliste asked to woodcutter. So the woodcutter replied, "Not at all. Ask whatever you want." Means woodcutter was saying, "I will not mind. You can ask questions whatever you want." So Mian Baliste said, "This morning you told me that you blew on your hands to warm them up in the morning." He was blowing on his hand to warm them up. "Now you are blowing on these potatoes, which is already so hot. Why do you want to make it hotter?" So what that Mian Baliste thought, that when woodcutter was blowing on his hand to keep them warm, same thinking he has applied over here for potatoes. That he was thinking that when woodcutter is blowing on potatoes, then the potatoes will become more warm. और दैट मियान बलिस्ते वॉज आस्किंग वाई डू यू वॉन्ट टू मेक इट हॉटर बिकॉज ऑलरेडी द पोटैटो इज हॉट एंड इफ यू विल ब्लो एन ऑन इट इट विल बिकम मोर हॉटर सो नो नो माई लिटिल फ्रेंड सेड वुडकटर दिस पोटैटो इज टू हॉट आई एम ब्लोइंग ऑन इट टू कूल इट डाउन सी द अपोजिट सिचुएशंस ओके सो वेन ही हर्ड दिस मियान बलिस्तेज फेस बिकम वाइट He began to tremble with fear and started to back away. The woodcutter was a good man. He said, "What's wrong, Mian? Are you trembling because of the cold?" So, but Mian Baliste kept going backwards. When he was a safe distance away, he said to himself, "What kind of a creature is this? Surely he must be a ghost or a jinn." Blow hot, blow cold, with the same breath. It is not just possible. That's right. There are some things which just cannot be, but they are. And here down it is written Zakir Hussain. So these are here you can see children three situations. In the first situation, Mian Baliste was blowing on his hand. To keep them warm. In the second situation, you can see the Mian Baliste was blowing on the wood to burn it. And in third situation, Mian Baliste was blowing on hot potatoes to keep it cool. Here three situations are there, but that Mian Baliste got confused in that only that. Mian Baliste that woodcutter was blowing on his hands to keep them warm. So he thought that when he that woodcutter when blew on hot potatoes to keep them cool. So that Mian Baliste thought that when he was blowing on hot potatoes, the potatoes will become more hot. But it is not like that. So here you should note down one point that. It depends upon the situation. Means in the first situation, hands were too cold, and the breath which is coming out from mouth that was warmer as compared to cool hands and outer cold atmosphere. But in second situation, when Mian Baliste in the third situation when Mian Baliste was blowing on hot potatoes, the potatoes were very hot, and the breath which is coming out from mouth. That was not as warmer as hot potato. So that is cool as compared to that hot potato. That is the reason behind that. Potatoes were too hot. That's why it can cool it. Okay. As your when your tea or your milk is too hot, at that time if you will blow on it, so it will cool down that tea or that milk. But if your hands are too cold and if you will blow on it, so because of this too coolness, that breath which is coming out from your mouth, that is warmer as compared to your hands and outer atmosphere. So that is only the reason behind it. So you should not get confused in between these situations, just like Mian Baliste. So Mian Baliste was confused when he saw the woodcutter blowing on his cold hands to make them warm and on the hot potatoes to cool them. So have you warmed your hands in winter by blowing on them when they are cold? And how do you feel? So you have to write that. Then blow hard from your mouth onto your hands. How did you find the air from your mouth as compared to the air around? And here you will get the answer. That the air around you or the thing which is in front of you and the coolness and hotness it depends upon that whether the material or the suppose potatoes or anything is too hot and if you will blow on it it is cool so it will make the particular thing cool. Now put your hands at some distance from your mouth and blow again. Does the air from your mouth feel warm and why? So you have to find out that answers. So children, here we have seen some situations in the story of that Mian Baliste and the woodcutter. So here you can experience that same situations in your daily life and you can get the answer. And it is totally depends upon the coolness and hotness. So in the next videos, we will be watching activities related to this hotness and coolness. So thank you for watching video. Read lesson very carefully, find out the hard words meanings. Thank you.